So over the last couple of years, we've done a lot of consultation with teachers, with candidates, with our overseas markets and the markets in the UK, just finding out what works with the syllabus and what areas we could improve. And one of the things that's come across most strongly in this is the importance of the repertoire lists, whether candidates are forming their programmes from these repertoire lists or whether they're using them as the basis for own choice works. So for the new syllabus, we've done a lot of work on refreshing the repertoire lists and most importantly, extending them, extending their length and incorporating a wider range of styles in the pieces that they represent. So we've worked with our instrumental specialists and a lot of the new items which we've added to the lists have come from them. But in fact, the majority of pieces that we've added have actually come through past candidates. We've trawled through our list of submitted repertoire for own choice, which has been approved in the past, and we've included as much of that as we can on the lists. And I think this is a really good way of ensuring that the lists actually reflect what people want to play in the exams, because it comes from what people have played in the past. In fact, we're going to carry on this process throughout the life of the syllabus. You'll notice that the repertoire lists were going to be available online as downloads rather than incorporated into the syllabuses. And this will allow us to update them periodically by adding own choice repertoire which has been approved for use by candidates in their exams. One of the other things that came out of the consultation was the importance that candidates place on the diplomas being so performance based. So we've decided to tweak the mark scheme slightly in the new syllabus. So instead of being worth 90 marks, the recital element will now be worth 96 marks. In this way, candidates can be sure that the mark they get fully reflects their performance ability. As a result of this, there are fewer marks available for the written programme, and as such, we are reducing the requirements for the written programme. So at ATCL and LTCL levels, we are removing the requirement for detailed programme notes on the pieces. At FTCL, we're retaining the requirement to include programme notes. This keeps it in line with other Level 7 qualifications. And we're very excited to launch the new syllabus and repertoire lists that we've put together.